to make ends meet. So this means that you're making enough money to pay your bills, but just barely enough. You're just barely making ends meet. When you make ends meet, when someone uses this phrase, it's not exactly positive. It's kind of just like, oh, they're just barely getting enough money to survive. You know, they have enough money just to pay their electricity bill and to pay their rent and then eat enough food for that day. So it's kind of like they're just scraping by. They just barely have enough money. So an example of this is a family. Maybe there's a mom who's a single mother, right? And she has three kids. That's really hard. You know, she only has one paycheck. She has to feed all three mouths. Usually, maybe she's just making ends meet. Some similar expressions would be to survive, to just to get by. If you're saying you just get by, that means you're just barely making enough money. If you're just paying your bills, those are all similar expressions.
What is this expression that Korean people use a lot, which is live hand to mouth, live from hand to mouth?
That's another similar expression, to live hand to mouth. That means like right when you're getting your money, it's going straight to your mouth, right? You're spending that money straight on food or your bills. You need that money at that second to live. If you keep studying with us and you learn English really well, maybe you'll get that really good job and you'll be way past making ends meet. You'll be making so much money, you'll never have to worry about making ends meet.
English.
자, 오늘 표현입니다. 오늘 표현은요. 자, 먹고 사는 것과 관련된 표현인데요. 자, 여러분들. 정말 힘들 때요. 우리 기본적인 생활만 할 수 있잖아요. 그렇죠? 예를 들어서 내가 진짜 열심히 일하고 있는데 상황이 안 좋아졌어요. 비즈니스가. 그래서 요즘은 진짜 내가 투잡을 뛰면서 그냥 간신히 먹고 살 수 있습니다. 이렇게 말을 할 때는요. Make ends meet. 이런 표현을 사용합니다. Make ends meet. 결국은 뭐냐면 간신히 정말 진짜 간신히 먹고 살 수 있을 정도만 벌 때 I make ends meet 이렇게 생각할 수 있다는 것이죠. 그렇죠? 자, make ends meet과 비슷한 표현을 정의를 해본다면요. Get by라는 표현이 꽤 많이 나옵니다. I'm just getting by. I'm just getting by. 나 그냥 어느 정도 먹고 살 수 있어. 그 정도의 느낌. I'm just getting by. 그 다음에 I'm just scraping by. I'm just scraping by. 이것도 마찬가지로 getting by와 거의 비슷한 표현이고 그냥 긁는 정도, 약간 느낌이 뭐냐면 정말 간신히 산다라는 그런 표현으로 기억하고 있으면 될 것 같습니다. 자, 그 다음에 또 종종 들리는 표현이 바로 뭐냐면요. Live from hand to mouth. 아니면 from을 빼고요. Live hand to mouth라는 표현인데요. 우리가 열심히 일을 하잖아요. 그렇죠? 그럼 돈이 들어오죠. 딱 돈을 잡았어요. 근데 이 돈으로 바로 이제 입으로 간다라는 것은 먹는 데 쓴다라는 거예요. 그러니까 다른 어떠한 여가 생활이나 이런 걸 즐길 수 있는 그런 건 없고요. 바로 그냥 먹는 데만 바쁘다. 먹고 살기 바쁘다. 한국말로도 그런 말이 있네요. 먹고 살기 바쁘다. 그런 말이 바로 live from hand to mouth. live hand to mouth라는 표현이 됩니다. 자, 그리고 이렇게 먹고 살기 힘들 때 우리는요, 절약하는 게 필요합니다. 그죠? 그래서 절약하다라는 표현할 때, 물론 save money 이런 표현도 사용할 수 있겠지만, tight my belt라는 표현도 사용할 수 있고요. 그 다음에 stretch my dollar. Stretch my dollar라고 해서 달러가 있잖아요. 그렇죠? 달러가 있는 돈이 있는데 돈을 최대한 아껴 쓰는 느낌이에요. 그러니까 늘려갖고 그냥 이거를 오랫동안 쓰는 느낌을 생각하시면 Stretch my dollar라는 표현도 절약하다라는 표현으로 이해할 수 있을 겁니다.
Even some medalists are unable to make ends meet and live close to the poverty line. Even some medalists are unable to make ends meet and live close to the poverty line. Even some medalists are unable to make ends meet and live close to the poverty line. Even some medalists are unable to make ends meet and live close to the poverty line. Even some medalists are unable to make ends meet and live close to the poverty line.
I'm tired of having to take temp jobs just to make ends meet. I'm tired of having to take temp jobs just to make ends meet. I'm tired of having to take temp jobs just to make ends meet. I'm tired of having to take temp jobs just to make ends meet. I'm tired of having to take temp jobs just to make ends meet.
They're going to have to work till they're about 67 or 70 simply to be able to get by. They're going to have to work till they're about 67 or 70 simply to be able to get by. They're going to have to work till they're about 67 or 70 simply to be able to get by. They're going to have to work till they're about 67 or 70 simply to be able to get by. They're going to have to work till they're about 67 or 70 simply to be able to get by.
자, 이렇게 해서 오늘 make ends meet와 비슷한 표현 살펴봤고요. 그 다음에 절약하다라는 표현까지 제가 여러분들한테 알려드렸습니다. 상당히 많은 표현을 배웠는데요. 한번 다시 돌아가서 다시 한번 영상을 보는 것도 도움이 되겠죠? 자, 우리 그러면 또 다음 시간에 또 뵙도록 하겠습니다. 자, see you guys next time. Take care. Bye bye.